I'm honored to be given the chance to address the school board this evening about the deplorable action of closing the snack line this year in the school. Oh, wait a moment. Oh, sorry. Okay, let's try that again. Good evening. Good evening to everyone, family and friends, teachers and administrators, and my fellow classmates. Which is something I'm saying for a final time this evening. I'm honored and humbled by the chance to speak before you on this most memorable of nights. I will attempt to keep my words as brief as possible, as I can see all the little children waiting for promised ice cream, and all the older children beside me waiting to strip off synthetic graduation robes. I can physically feel the tension here tonight, an internal struggle within us all, a desire to spring through the door into the wide open and waiting world, pitted against a want to stay here in the safety and comfort of our closest friends. It's as if we all know there lies a city of gold beyond the next rise, waiting for us, and yet we are all afraid to leave the safety of our village of clay to travel there. Not that I'm saying Chazy is a village of clay, that would be far too cruel a comparison. It is a lovely, heartwarming hometown. I merely want to emphasize the limitless opportunities waiting for us outside of this place. What is the human condition if it is not to dream and pursue happiness, completion? Each of us contains a vague sense of that now, like a young deck scrubber's first voyage on a schooner out on the open sea. The world opens up, and one can feel the lightness of time, the heaviness of emotions, and the indescribable taste of adventure. That's what I feel now, like that deck scrubber, stepping across a plank from the land to ship, to be borne off to a distant, exotic, inverted shore. That is looking ahead, something we will oft repeat in the coming days. This night, however, is also about considering the past, where we do come from. We were born, most of us, about 18 years ago, with minds ready to absorb knowledge, to adapt understanding, to learn to be human. One must ask just how much is present in that vacuous mind as it emerges into the world. How much identity is there before seconds lend themselves to minutes, to hours, to days, to weeks, to fortnights, to months, to years, to decades, to centuries? How has it unique persons emerge from the masses, the seas of humanity? Our forming is in part a condition of our forebears, those who populate the environment of our upbringing, our parents. But I sincerely and heartily believe that we are born with at least the seed of identity. I enlist in not such foolish paradoxes as destiny, but in a simple logic that every seed stands alone, is unique, and yet is irrevocably tied to the whole of creation. We people, brought to this world at the height of love or passion, we are born with a part of which will later become a whole. Some of us will rise to meet our expectations, or perhaps, to surpass them. Other of us will fight for our chance in life and will prosper. Existence is made of these crucial junctures, points at which obscurity and reality tilt, and distinguishing a no-win scenario from no-lose scenario is nigh impossible. We stand at such a tipping point. The ending of our time here is a culmination, a conclusion, and a prelude, a turning over. As we pass from this mode of living to our adult lives, identity is not lost, but transferred. We are today what we will be, seeds grown to saplings, hair-like strands ready to take root, such that the sapling may become a blossoming tree. So lie the 38 of us today. Ready and willing we are to embrace those memories which are ingrained so deeply in our souls, penned with the most permanent of inks. True, it may be slightly disheartening to consider we've spent 13 years securing an education, only to come to the conclusion that our education is only just beginning. Like ending a long trek through dry lands, only to spot the Sahara Desert over the next rise. For most of us, that next big challenge, the next installment of our life and education, is college. Not that I'm relating our college years to trekking through the Sahara. I'm sure all of our respective universities will have an ample water supply. I only mean that we are rising up from one stage and passing instantly into the next. 10 happy miles down in life, and 10,000 glorious miles left to go. But none of us will soon forget those early years or the people that came to be so precious. I'm sure all of us, for the rest of our time on this earth, will look back fondly on those memorable moments. For example, I'll never forget when Mrs. Davis thought her kindergarten class should try raw potato slices, resulting in a mound of concealed potatoes behind a playhouse, and the look on the janitor's face when it was discovered months later. I'll never forget Mr. Lund and his ridiculous stories and lessons, like when he was teaching us of early nomads following game across the barren land bridge, at which point he put an animal fur on his head and began to chant, "Caribou, caribou," as he jutted a yardstick in the air as if it were a spear. I'll remember the good and bad times in the playground, from playing soccer on the big kids' field to losing a tooth after being hit by a soccer ball. I speak for my class when I say we've had phenomenal teachers through the years that not only imparted knowledge, but also made us better people and gave us a desire to learn and excel. We'll never forget these teachers. But most of all, I'll remember the quiet moments of the last few years, time that our class spent together, lunchtime spent in the library playing games, talking, and laughing. Periods in the senior lounge, talking about the past and the future, simply enjoying each other's company. Also, moments outside of school with our class, like the rafting trip, and yes, I'll admit it exists, the senior skip day. These are 37 people that I consider, in my mind, kin to family. There is no need for dishonesty between us, awkward moments, or explanation. We have grown up from childhood as a single unit, and we all know each other like siblings. These are not mere acquaintances we share, but bonds driven deep with trust, a sense of comrades that will last a lifetime. It would be hard to leave these connections, but we have to picture in our minds that city of gold lying over the next rise. The sun has risen, the dew is drying, and it's time for the saplings to reach towards the sun. Now that we've looked backward, I would like to speak directly toward my class for a moment and look towards the future. Many of you at this point may not have any inkling of what you wish to pursue in life. You may feel that the things you love have no practical application in your life and will force you to find something else that seems doable. I say reject these thoughts before you exit this group. Never settle on anything in life when dealing with matters of the heart, and what career you follow is certainly contained in this category. You may not know what you enjoy now, but as in all matters of love, you'll know conclusively when you find it. It may be impossible to connect the dots right now, but do not be afraid. If you're doing what you enjoy, it'll work out okay. Do not be too timid to follow what you love. Just remember that the only way to do great work is to be passionate, and the only way to be passionate is to be sincere. A large portion of your life will be spent working, so make it one of the best parts if you can. Don't be trapped by dogma and end up living someone else's life. We are all young now, but as we grow and experience more and accumulate more responsibilities, we have to maintain focus. We have to capture in our hearts what we are feeling right now at this instant. We have to maintain an ethos of hope and youth. Steve Jobs once gave the commencement speech at Stanford University, and he closed by telling the class to stay hungry, stay foolish. And that is what I wish for all of us now, as we go, to stay hungry and to stay foolish. Another man, Steve Jobs' favorite singer, Bob Dylan, once sang, "And may you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you stay forever young." Thank you. And forget about good luck, rise and conquer.
Thank you, Chris, affectionately known as Brewster, by his classmates and also faculty and staff. I also would like to point out, Chris, that since this neckline has been closed, I've lost 10 pounds. Thank you, Mark. Welcome, everyone. I would like to recognize our 50-year alumni members, the class of 1959. They would please stand. Ben-Hur. Who was the best actor in that movie?
Charles.
Very good. Okay, now for a toughie. The song of the year was The Battle of New Orleans. Who sang that?
Johnny Hart. Johnny Hart.
You don't want me to sing a few lines in it, do you? As a housekeeping chore, I have been asked to announce that the flowers up front here not being removed. They will be used by the Alumni Association for their annual banquet tomorrow night at the Sacred Heart Parish Center. I would now ask Mrs. Nancy Resco to please come forward. Thank God she has her voice tonight.
Above and Beyond Award, $210. This award is given to a Chazy senior who has exhibited extraordinary spirit in regard to Chazy's traditions and dedication to academic success. Emily Gilmore. $300 awarded to a deserving student to whom our organization wishes the best of luck as they pursue their career choice. Samantha Morse. Amy Beth Gallagher Memorial Scholarship Trust. $5,000 over a four-year period. This trust was created in loving memory of Amy by her parents, and will be awarded annually to a student whose high school performance exhibits similar interests and characteristics. Stephanie Pepper. Ann P. Carpenter Memorial Scholarship. $500 given to a senior attending college. Sarah Gravel. $500. This scholarship assists the recipient in obtaining an undergraduate degree in a field related to clinical service for the developmentally disabled. Bridget Dahl. Auxiliary of CBPH Medical Center Healthcare Career Scholarship. $1,000. This award is presented to assist a student entering a healthcare profession. Lindsay Seymour. Ryan Glenn Ledoux Memorial Scholarship. $500. This scholarship was created in memory of Ryan Glenn Ledoux and is awarded to a senior who exhibits the willingness to set goals, work hard, and achieve success. Sarah Gravel. $500, Stephanie Pepper. $500, Megan Ryan. $500, Lindsay Seymour. Shawnee Trombley. Chazy CSEA Award, $100. This award is given to a graduating senior whose parent is a member of the Civil Service Employees Association, Local 810 of the Chazy Central Rural School. Lucas Lauren. $100, Jennifer Levine. Chazy Hardware Scholarship, $100, given to a student who excelled in the Industrial Arts Program, Edward Pelkey. Chazy Homestead Restaurant Award. This award is given to a student who achieves academic success through a commitment to hard work. $50, Sarah Gravel. $50, Lucas Lauren. $50, Stephanie Pepper. $75, Megan Ryan. $100, Lindsay Seymour. $50, Shawnee Tromley. Chazy Lions Club Scholarship, given to a senior continuing on to college. $300, Bridget Dahl. $300, Sarah Gravel. $300, Stephanie Pepper. $300, Megan Ryan. Chazy Parent Teacher Organization Scholarship. This award is given to a deserving student. $250, Candace Panetta. $250, Shawnee Palmley. Chazy Senior Citizen Organization Award. This award is given to a deserving student pursuing their dream. $50, Shawnee Tromley. Chazy Teachers Association Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a senior who is continuing his or her education and has an English average of 3.5 or higher at the end of the seventh semester, and also maintain a passing grade for his or her reading contract. $350, Stephanie Pepper. Chazy and Westport Telephone Corporation Award. Given to an employee's dependent for outstanding academic achievement in math and science. $250, Stephanie Pepper. Chazy and Westport Telephone Corporation Scholarship, $1,000, given to a senior with the highest four-year average in math and science, Christopher Brewster. This scholarship provides full tuition to an incoming freshman who has earned a high school average of 90 or above. $3,400, renewable for 2 years, Elizabeth Battle. $3,400, renewable for 2 years, Lindsay Seymour. $400, we know over 2 years, Shawnee Tromble. Clinton County Association of Town Highway Superintendents Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to a senior in honor of Richard Lewis, Superintendent of the Town of Chazy. $500, Stephanie Pepper. Johnny Chomley. Cultural Diversity Committee of Clinton Correctional Facility Award. This award is given with intentions to help a senior plan their future, be it continuing their education, entering the military service, or gaining work experience. $100, Megan Ryan. David Kendall Martin Scholarship. This scholarship is given to an independent paper. $500 savings bond, Christopher Brewster. Scholarship is given in recognition of a student's achievements in chemistry. $100, Stephanie Pepper. Donald B. Robinson Scholarship, given to a graduate who will continue her education in an accredited program who shows integrity, respect, and also demonstrates interest in the community. $500, Candace Panetta. Memorial Scholarship. student pursuing their education at Clinton Community College. $600, Lindsay Seymour. New York State Lottery Leader for Tomorrow Scholarship. This scholarship award is intended for a student who is involved in many areas of high school life, not just academics. $5,000 over 4 years, Lindsay Seymour.
$100
for Injuru. $100, Olivia Gay. $100, Keegan Latchmore. $100, Lucas Warren. $100, Stephanie Pepper. St. John's University Presidential Scholarship. This scholarship is renewable for 4 years and will provide full tuition for each year and is in recognition of fine academic achievement. $30,750, Christopher Bruce. $5,800, renewable for 4 years, Christopher Bruce. St. Lawrence University, Hawkesbury North Country Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a senior in acknowledgement of outstanding academic and personal achievements. $20,000, renewable for 4 years, Jennifer Levine. Salute to Labor Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a student who has expressed the importance of voting in all elections. $300, Stephanie Pepper. $200, Keegan Latchmore. Theodore and Lillian Teves Award, given to a student who has overcome difficulties through determination and a strong work ethic. $250, Lucas Lauren. $4,000 renewable for 4 years, Corinne Giroux. University of New Hampshire Dean's Scholarship. This award is given in recognition of this student's outstanding academic record. $6,000 renewable for 4 years, Stephanie Tucker. $4,000 renewable for 4 years, Stephanie Pepper. University of New Hampshire Tuition Grant. This grant is given to help offset tuition costs for non-residents. $9,000 renewable for 4 years, Stephanie Pepper. $1,000 renewable for 4 years, Megan Ryan. University of Vermont Scholarship. This award is presented based on out-of-state residency and full-time enrollment. $3,000, Megan Ryan. Given to help offset tuition costs $11,965, Megan Ryan. Upward Bound Senior Award. This award is presented to a student who has participated in the Upward Bound program. $75, Candace Panetta. Upward Bound Student Advisory Board Award. This award is presented to a student who participated on the Upward Bound Student Advisory Board. $75, Candace Panetta. Woodman of the World Lodge 462 Andy Spear Memorial Scholarship Fund. This award is presented to a student who has been a member of Woodman of the World for at least 1 year. The student must be active in his or her community and be in good academic standing. $200, Stephanie Pepper. Wyeth Laboratory Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a student of a Wyeth employee pursuing a career in math or science. $1,000, Megan Ryan.
I think Mrs. Vesco needs a big round of applause. I need to realize, talking to the microphone, she was on her tiptoes the whole time. Before we present the diplomas, I would like to take a moment to thank the students, parents, faculty, and staff at the CCRS for another successful year. I'd like to also point out that there are 38 people up here on stage. We are in a recession worldwide in this country. Tonight, they were given out for a small school $448,200 in scholarships. Vice President of the Board of Education, please come up to help present the diplomas.
Amanda Grace Barfield. daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Leo Barnard. Amanda will attend Flushing Community College. Paige Marie Bashaw, daughter of Mrs. Tina Brothers and Mr. Kenneth Bashaw. Paige will attend Champlain College of Vermont. Laura Marie Bradley, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Charles Bradley. Laura will attend Clinton Community College. daughter of Mr. Michael LaPorte and Ms. Heidi LaPorte. Megan will enter the workforce. Keegan Curtis Lattimore, son of Mr. and Mrs. Curtis Lattimore. Keegan will attend Seton Tech as a post-camp graduate. Lucas Michael Lauren, son of Mr. and Mrs. Leo Lauren. Lucas will enter the workforce. Jennifer Lynn Levine, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Peter Levine. Jennifer will attend St. Lawrence University.
Thank you.
April Lee Shambo, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Francis Shambo. April will like to enter the workforce. Jessica Ray Tebow, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Robert Tebow. Jessica will attend Cedar Crest College.
Central Rural School Board of Education, I present to you the class of 2009. Join us in singing the alma mater, the words are on the back of the program.